Right, so just tell us a little bit about your films. James, you did Ginger, that's right, isn't it? Yeah. Tell us a little bit about the background for the film Ginger.
Ginger is part of my final, my third year at uni. I went to make a final film.
Oh, you were telling me.
I was in a group of four people, and we named ourselves Northern Monsters. We decided that we weren't just doing a course, we wanted to make films we also enjoy doing. So we ended up making two films, one I made, which was Ginger, and one my friend Jordan wrote and directed, which is called Last Day. I found a lot of my peers were doing films like gangsters or monsters. I'm like, I don't know anything about gangsters or monsters in Omskirt. I'm posh up there. But I do know fairy tales and nursery rhymes, so I'm going to do something that I quite enjoy. And I knew Leo, who was Ginger, obviously, from Bury Youth Theatre at the Met. And I knew I had an actor, I knew a theme that I wanted to go down. I thought, what's Ginger? What can I do with Ginger Boy? Oh, Ginger Man. So I went with that, really.
It's a really good idea, it's a real good premise as well. Is there a bit of fantasy in there as well, being able to create your own...
your own plan.
Yeah, well, I made a boy, essentially. I've always liked fantasy. I mean, originally I wanted to do something fantasy about an imaginary friend, about a boy who wanted to cling on to being young, but my ideas were far too expensive and far too grand, so I was like, can you just... It's smaller now. But I still wanted to play the idea of doing something quite fantastical.
Yeah. I know, obviously, the casting's quite important for when you're doing comedies, and you think you got your casting right, but I don't know how you cast for a gingerbread man. So tell me a little bit about that and how you decided to cast the way that you did cast.
I knew Leo from BYT, so that was an easy one for me. I'm the boy, he was in it, I'm blonde now. I wasn't supposed to be in it originally. The actor we had pulled out last minute, which left me in a bit of a panic, so I was like, ah, crap, what do we do? So I just said, okay, say a few lines, I'll do it.
Is this your first screening?
I've done a bit of theatre stuff, but...
Is this the first
time? Oh, yeah, it's the first time I've ever shown something, yeah, so I'm a little bit nervous.
Obviously, it's got plenty of laughs, so it's achieved its goal that it's a comedy, so were you pleased with the response?
Yeah, I'm glad, I heard a few R's at the end, so I'll get a few tears for the dummy, so we'll get that.
Sophie, just explain to us a little bit about your film, give us the background on your film as well.
So I wanted to make a sci-fi because I'm a big fan of sci-fi since I was quite little, but due to budget constraints I kind of wanted to concentrate more on the story of the family, and at the time I was writing it, I was reading The Road as well, so that was one of my big influences. Like, you come across these characters that you don't really know much about, and you experience things with them that way, but not much of their background is given away, so you have to kind of guess things. So I just wanted to give a few hints about their life through the photographs and stuff like that, but leave a lot of it to the audience imagination, and at the end as well you can decide what happens to their boy.
A lot of those kind of films are left open-ended, it's left to the audience's imagination as to what's actually gone on. Did you actually have it scripted, or did you have something in mind that had actually happened or not?
I think that he probably died at the end, that was my initial thoughts, but now I just wanted to leave it open so that people could think for themselves about it.
And there's some really nice cinematography in there as well, and I also noticed that the soundtrack was really quite nice as well, lots of impending doom. So what's actually happened, what's gone wrong with the world, why those two lies there?
The idea was that aliens come down in the 2012, like a lot of people are conspiratorising about, and just destroy the Earth. So my idea that there would be quite a lot of different groups kind of hiding out, so I just wanted to concentrate on one group story through this.
And was there anything else that inspired it? I know that, you know, when there's a recession on, those kind of films don't tend to be in the cinema so much. There's lots of happy films, but... So, kind of like, was the your intention of the film, were you happy the way that it kind of connected to, you know, to the audience?
Yeah, and there was quite a big trend while it was being made for these kind of post-apocalyptic movies, so it kind of fit into that. And I was kind of influenced by the film Monsters as well, so those kind of monster movies as well.
Where did you shoot it?
It was in a friend's basement, so we were quite lucky. we took over it for a few weeks.
So did you have to do anything to that basement, or was it always that scruffy?
It was pretty scruffy, but we had to like wreck a few mattresses and paint mould on the wall, that kind of stuff.
Okay. You, Jane, you've just graduated, is that correct?
Yes, from Mitchell.
So is that how many shorts have you made? Is that the first one, or have you made a series?
No, I've made a few shorts. This is probably the longest shorts I've made. But yeah, I've made a few.
Is there anything that you do differently if you went back and had to shoot these things? Yeah.
Yes.
I suppose that's to both of you.
Yeah. I wouldn't be in it, for one. I possibly might change the way I approach directing with one of the actors, because I felt like I didn't really get the most out of that with girl. I felt like I should have pushed it more a little bit. But other than that, I was fairly happy with how it went.
I'm quite happy with it, but I think maybe next time I'd like to try for a bit more dialogue, because there was a few scenes that I did have
I think it worked really well with that dialogue, actually.
Oh, that's good then.
Yeah. But, you know.
That's
all right
then.
Yeah, and kind of like, I was going to ask you about the flashbacks as well, kind of like, you know, did you consider putting more of those in, and was there any of the scripts on your one particular that was improv, you know?
Yeah, quite a lot of it was improv, like the dinner table scene. The guys kind of came up with that themselves, and there were more flashbacks, but I cut them out in the end, but due to time. But yeah, there was a few more written in the actual script.
And what about you, James? Was it the same thing to you, really? Was it really tightly storyboarded, or was it, you know?
Yeah, I mean, there were a few things we had to cut out just because of time, but we pretty much kept to the original thing. I mean, we threw out a few things that weren't entirely necessary. I think we would have done so in the end anyway.
But. And I suppose the question to both of you, what's the plan now that you've graduated?
Will someone hire me, please? I'm not joking. I'm hoping to travel in summertime, so until then I'll just be continuing to work on shorts and be more creative.
Well, I suppose Manchester circuit's quite a small circuit, so...
Yeah.
They're all here. Yeah, the same question for you.
Yeah, that's the same for me. I'll just carry on working on my own shorts and see if we can get involved with a few more as well.
That's great. I will obviously really enjoy both those shorts, and they were a great success. So, yeah, great.